Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us today in this new Azure Portal How To video. Today, we learn how to apply data visualization to your Azure resources. And for that, we have Adrian Chan, who's going to show us how to do that with the Azure Portal. So thank you very much for joining us today, Adrian.
Thank you, Leon. It's a pleasure to be here today to talk to you about a new powerful capability we offer to help you visualize a summary of your resources. For example, you can now view all your resources all on one map. This is very powerful if you are a visual learner or you need to manage your resources by a specific property. Remember, location is just one of the many examples. Now let me show you how this works. Right now in the portal, I am looking at a list view of all my resources. You can get to here by searching all resources or in the left navigation here. So as you can see, I have many resources. And because of this, it's hard to see an overall picture or the big picture of my resources. To help with this, we now have a new feature called the Summary View. You can get to it by this dropdown here on the right. Right now you're seeing a list view, and you can go ahead and click into Summary View. And here you'll see the exact example I was explaining earlier, where you see a summary count of your resources by location on a map. So let's say I just see this visual and I see something interesting and I want to learn more about it. I can definitely click into it to drill down. So this is ECUS, I see 36 resources. Click here. Now I'll get a list of those 36 resources which I can investigate or go to. And so say now I'm done with ECUS 2, and for example, I wanna take a look at North Europe. I can click onto North Europe, and again, this list updates to show the resources by North Europe location. Now say I wanna go back to the map view, I just have to close out of this drill down, and I'm back here. So we have many ways you can see your data. It's not just in a map view. You can choose for a bar chart, a donut chart, or even simply just a list. And on top of that, location, as I explained, was just one of the many examples that we offer. You can also take a look at resource group summary, which will count your resources by resource groups, by type, and by subscription. You can also choose how you'd like to see your data, top 10, bottom 10. And if you'd like to see all of it, you can go to the list view. So say now I go back to my location view. I want to show you that all the features that you had in the list view before also apply here in this visualization summary view. So for example, you can refresh your data and you can use any of these filters and they'll be applied to your visualizations. So for example, if I only want locations in East Australia, and let's say Brazil South. There I have it filtered to just those two locations now. Now, what makes this really powerful as well is right now we're on all resources, but we can even go into this view for a resource-specific insights. So for example, if I want to take a look at app services, there might be some information that only applies to app services that I would like to know. I can just go into the app services list view, switch to summary view. And again, you'll see like the location, resource group, subscription, which I showed you earlier in all resources. But now because we are in app services specifically, we have these other fields that apply specifically to app services. So for example, I can take a look at app type. I'll see my app type summary. I'll have web apps, function apps, and API apps. And again, I can go ahead, click into here, it'll drill down and I'll see that full list of resources that are of type web app. To show you another example, I'd like to show you the status. So we've been seeing a lot of bar charts, and what I want to show you now is you can also take a look at a donut chart. And voila, there you have your donut chart with running and stopped status. Now, app services, again, was just one example that I gave. Most of the resources across Portal will have this kind of experience where you can go into the summary view and take a look at the general summarizations and also if the resource has any specific properties that you can summarize on. So let me show you one more example. Let's say we go to resource groups. Again, as you can see, it looks the same. I can go to summary view. I see the ones that apply, location and subscription. And then on top of that, I have status that will apply to resource groups. So if I click into status here, you can see that all my resource groups succeeded. So as you can see, there's many possibilities that you can take a look into for the summary view and on many different types of resources, or even all your resources all together. I hope that you like this feature and you can play around with it, and hopefully I'll give you a lot of insights into your resources that you weren't aware of before.
Thank you very much, Adrian. This is great. And thanks every one of you for watching. Please try this out in your Azure environment. Let us know what you think. What else would you like to see? Leave us a comment in the comment section, follow us on Twitter, and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks for watching.